Let's begin the show with Afghanistan, where the brutal jihadi group Taliban have successfully seized power. Desperate Afghans are rushing to Kabul airport to flee the country, and various heart-wrenching videos of the takeover are flooding social media. With the fear of mass displacement of people from their homes, Afghanistan is now facing a humanitarian crisis. When the country is in chaos right now, one of its immediate neighbors is celebrating the Taliban's takeover. This immediate neighbor is no other than Pakistan. A report.
A desperate woman is handing over her child to a US soldier above Kabul airport wall so that her baby can be evacuated from the country and saved from the Taliban. She doesn't know whether she will be able to see her child again or not. Kabul airport has become a picture of chaos and desperation after the fall of Afghanistan into the hands of Taliban. People at the airport are begging American forces to be saved. Up the road, the Taliban are controlling the crowds trying to reach the airport. They are firing into the air, pushing people and beating them with guns. Several deaths have been reported in the intermittent firing taking place outside the airport. Afghans fear that they have been abandoned, and the women in particular are the most at danger. The Taliban return is catastrophic for them.
کسی به ما اهمیت نمیده و ما توی تاریخ هم میمیریم. خیلی خنده دارم.
The entire world is shocked, and the United Nations has expressed deep concern over the Taliban takeover. Many countries are sending military flights to rescue their nationals from Afghanistan. However, one country is celebrating the fall of Kabul. This one country is no other than Pakistan, which has historic ties with Taliban. Leaders of Pakistan are openly congratulating the Taliban, and many media workers in Islamabad are also joining the celebrations. Over the last three decades, Pakistan has viewed the Taliban as serving a twofold purpose. First, a Taliban regime in Kabul would ensure the Pakistan military a free pass over Afghanistan, a territory that it has coveted for strategic depth in its enmity with India. And second, it will ensure Pakistan agencies access over Afghan routes into Central Asia. Hence, Prime Minister Imran Khan is himself endorsing the Taliban taking over Kabul by saying that Afghans have broken the shackles of slavery in the war-torn country.
جب آپ ذہنی غلام بنتے ہیں تو یہ یاد رکھیں اصل غلامی سے زیادہ بری ذہنی غلامی ہے ذہنی غلامی کی زنجیریں توڑنا زیادہ مشکل ہوتا ہے جو ابھی افغانستان میں غلامی کی زنجیریں تو توڑ دی انہوں نے لیکن جو ذہنی غلامی کی زنجیریں وہ نہیں ٹوٹتی
The Taliban is undoubtedly seen as a proxy group in Pakistan, and therefore Islamabad has been providing the Taliban shelter in the country for decades. The safe havens for Taliban have existed in Pakistan virtually from the start of the US War on Terror in 2001. Washington was aware of this, but because its need for Pakistan as a logistics back end for the war in Afghanistan was greater, it didn't push the Pakistan military sufficiently to act against these safe havens. Throughout the period, fighters of Afghan Taliban and its associate, the Haqqani Network, along with Al-Qaeda and a gaggle of other jihadists, have been crossing in and out of Afghanistan under the benevolent gaze of Pakistan Army. In the recent fighting that took Taliban all the way to Kabul, the same safe havens in Pakistan were used to launch their attacks in Afghanistan.
These are not your daddy's Taliban. These are 2.0 Taliban. Well-trained, well-equipped, disciplined, So, and where do they come from? Well, they certainly were not indigenously built in Afghanistan. And according to many reports, all of their wounded are being treated in Pakistani hospitals. Yet Pakistan doesn't know about it. Pakistani government doesn't know about it. Just like they didn't know about Osama bin Laden living in one of their most important military cities.
The Taliban victory could not have come without active assistance from Pakistan. Recently, Sheikh Rashid, a minister in Imran Khan's cabinet, admitted that Afghan Taliban wounded in the fighting were being treated in the hospitals in Pakistan. Moreover, as per the local sources, a large number of Pak-backed terrorists belonging to the Islamic State, Jaish-e-Mohammed and Lashkar-e-Taiba have already entered the Afghan capital, Kabul, in the last few days. The Taliban leadership is aware of the presence of these foreign terrorists who entered the city carrying Taliban flags.